Good afternoon, Holmes Road Church of Christ. I hope you're having a wonderful Wednesday. I hope you're happy and healthy and everything's going well for you. And hopefully we can get together and I'll see you soon. But I just wanted to give you a little thought to maybe brighten your week a little bit and maybe help you along your way. A little message from God's Word tonight. If you have your Bibles, I want you to turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and look at verses 26 through 27. Those verses say, "Brothers and sisters, think of what you were when you were called. Not many of you were wise by human standards, and not many of you were influential. Not many of you were of noble birth. But God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong." It's interesting in that particular verse, the word noble there in Greek. It's the compound word eugenes. And I know the eugene is often a word that is a name that we use here in English, but in Greek it's a compound word. The EU, it means EU in Greek meant well and good. The U, it means well and good. And then the genes, of course, as we get our, just like in English, the genes, like a human gene, means you were the things you're gifted when you were born, the genetic aspect of a human, and that's what it meant there. So compounding together the word eugenes in the Greek time, it meant people who were well known or who come from excellent genes. In ancient Greece, the term eugenes meant men of high class, such as kings and politicians or other such upper crust of society. They were the individuals who ancestors gave them their riches and the wealth, the blue-collar people, they were the famous, the cultured, the aristocrats. They were the type with all the finest of everything. Eugenes also became a word that was describing people of high intelligence, the geniuses, and their descendants. For instance, today we think Albert Einstein and his kids, they would be referred to as eugenes, because a genius, he would pass on his genius trait to his children. And so he was famous because of how smart he was. And that's also what eugenes kind of meant in the Greek language. In the verse that we just read, the verse of 1 Corinthians 1, 26 and 27, the verse tells us that God is not calling the upper crust of society to do his work. He calls just the regular folks, the ordinary folks, the usual, the simple, just the regular people. If you're an average person and not much education, not a lot of money, not a lot of talent, not a lot of anything that makes you stand out, then you're the kind of person that God is calling and wants to use. God does not call the eugenes of the world, but sometimes he does. Sometimes he calls eugenes, but for the most part, he just wants the everyday Joe. And that's who he calls to do his work. He chose, anyway, it's interesting as you read that verse, and in the verse 26 to 27 there, it says, "But God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise." And that word foolish there in the Greek, it's the word moreno, which we get the word moron. The word often, the world tends to view Christians maybe as idiots or dopes, fools, the imbeciles, jerks, or dimwits. And the word moreno there is often used during Paul's time, during that Greek time, to depict people who the world would make fun of and who the world would scorn. And so it says God chose those people, the people that the world would make fun of, the people that the world rejects and makes fun of and ridicules. God chooses them. So if any of you out there, if maybe you've been laughed at for your faith, maybe you've met some people who think they're far superior to you because you believe in the Bible, how silly. And you've been called stupid or an idiot or a jerk. Maybe you've been made fun of for the things that you believe in. Maybe you don't have the genius gene residing in your DNA. Maybe you haven't come from noticeable people. Maybe you're just an ordinary person, and the people made fun of you. Then rejoice, because God is calling you to do His work. You are just the kind of person God wants to accomplish the great things for His glory. I've heard elders ask people to do things such as teach class at church or lead a song or a prayer. And people say, well, I can't do that. I'm just some regular person. I can't get up there and expound on all this stuff. I don't have any talent. I'm not a great leader. I don't have the gift to do those things. Well, rejoice. If you're just a regular Joe and you're not a part of the upper crust or highly educated, rejoice. God is calling you. He wants to use you for His work. And that's my message for you this morning. Keep working for the Lord, and we'll see you soon.